name's Malcolm Norris from Sunstone Metals. Malcolm, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Andrew. It's great to be here.
Good to have you back here. $24 million in funding you've announced here. A great result. Break down the capital raise for us.
Yeah, Andrew, look, we're very pleased with how this has unfolded. We've been talking to a number of institutional funds over the last few months, and a significant majority of this funding, about 75% of the 20 million placement, has come in with really well-regarded funds. So that's a great sign of support for what Sunstone is doing. And we're really pleased to have them on board and to take this journey with us. We've also announced that we'll do a 4 million share placement plan. Shareholders should expect to see their documentation for that via email. If they're registered with Computershare, that should be coming out at the end of next week. That's a great opportunity for existing shareholders that have supported us very strongly over the last few years to participate in this raising as well. So overall, look, we're very pleased with the outcome. And importantly, it does give us a tick of approval for what we're doing and what we plan to do ahead of us.
Well, tell us more. What does this cash injection mean for Sunstone and for your key projects?
Yeah, look, it's very simple. And I mean, the Sunstone story is very simple. We've got two significant discoveries that we announced last year. Over the last 12 months, we've drilled about 20,000 metres. And that drilling has delivered two significant discoveries at Bramaderos and El Palmar. Over the next 12 months, we'll drill twice as many metres. You know, we're anticipating drilling at least 40,000 metres. I hope it's more, because if it's more than that, it means we're following up on good success. But we'll drill at least 40,000 metres. And a majority of that in the next 3 months will be focused on Bramaderos and Alba, because we've got three rigs working on that project right now, drilling 24/7. And the goal there is to have enough information for us to add that in to a mineral resource estimate that we're expecting to deliver before the end of the year. So that will be Alba plus Brahma. So that's part of the money that we've raised. A component of the funds will also be directed at testing some of the other targets at Bramaderos. Some of our shareholders may recall back in 2019 and 20, we drilled four holes at Limon. And we got some mineralization, but it wasn't quite good enough. But we've recently done some geophysics at Limon. That's generated a new series of targets. And we'll put a couple of holes in to have a look at that, see what we come up with. And then we've got about four other porphyry targets that need drilling. So all of that will be funded from this raise. The other large component of the funding, nearly 50%, will go to El Palmar, which was the discovery we announced last year in October. And this is a great project. It's a large project. We're now drilling hole 17. We've released up to hole 6. So we've got a lot of information still to be put out into the market. But all of these holes are extremely encouraging. We've got a large mineralized system. And so a lot of our drilling will be chasing shallow targets, deep targets, satellite targets. We're going to get a really good look at El Palmar over the next 6 to 9 months.
So big plans here for both of these projects, a bit nearer term. Malcolm, what news are you expecting?
Yeah, so near term, the next piece of news that will come out will be assays, we think, from three drill holes at Alba. So we've released results up to hole 23. Hole 22, investors may remember, ended in mineralization. We're at 0.8 grams of gold and nearly 0.2 copper in the last sample. So we extended that hole. We drilled another 130 meters. So we've got those assays to come back. So that's 22 extension, 24 and 25. And so those three holes, I'm hoping, will be available to be released very soon after Anzac Day. So last week of April. Then we're also expecting to see a batch of assays come back from El Palmar. So we're expecting to see holes 7, 8, and 9 come back. They will tell two stories. One is more drilling around holes 1 to 6. So 7 and 8 were in that area. And then hole 9 was our first attempt at a deep hole. Now that hole lifted and deviated, didn't quite go to target, but got some really interesting looking mineralization. So we'll release those results and provide some context for what's happening with the deep drilling at El Palmar. But you know, we're very excited by it. And so after that, we will have continuous results. What we have done, which is significant, is we've improved the processing of drill core that we manage before it goes to the laboratory. We've got more core saws. We've got more people cutting core. So that was a bit of a backlog. We've dealt with that, and we should start to see more frequent results coming through.
And I understand you're off to Ecuador shortly. Malcolm, what are your plans?
Yeah, I am. So I'm departing a week today, next Thursday, heading off to Ecuador. I'll go and see both projects. I'll spend a few days in Quito in meetings. I'll meet with some government officials. I'll meet with some of the other companies that are active in Ecuador. But I want to, you know, do a number of things. But one of the most important things is to meet a lot of our new employees, because I haven't been to Ecuador for 2 years and we've doubled the number of employees. So I've got a lot of people to meet. I'm looking forward to that. I've got a lot of communities to meet. So it'll be wonderful just to get back there and see firsthand all the good work that the Ecuadorian team has done.
Well, all the best for the trip, Malcolm. Thanks for your time.
Thanks very much, Andrew, and I'll see you when I get back with lots of news, I hope.